Hello, my dear students. Myself, Dr. Neelesh Kumar Gupta. Today, I will deliver a lecture on FIR filter design. In my previous lectures, I told you about the FIR filter design. And in this lecture also, I will take some examples based upon the designing of FIR digital filter using window techniques. And also, I will discuss about the other FIR filter designing method like frequency sampling method and Fourier series method. By these two methods also you can design the FIR digital filter. Generally, we prefer windowing techniques for FIR filter designing, and it can convert your impulse response and corresponding frequency coefficient, or you can say digital filter coefficients of finite duration. So, we come on our slide. So, this is the example. In last class, I told you about the windowing techniques, how you determine your filter coefficients and impulse response of FIR digital filter of finite duration by using window function. Similarly, we are taking here another examples. So, in this example, in the question, digital filter response is given to you. This response is given to you. It is 0 from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, and its value is e to the power minus j 2 omega from pi by 4 to pi. So, this is, you can say, example of high pass filter. Earlier in the previous class, we took the example of low pass filter. So, here high pass filter. So, this frequency response is given to you. Now, you have to again determine the filter coefficients, if and the window functions, rectangular window functions given to you, its value is 1 from n, small n, from 0 to 4. It means your length of the filter is here also 5, because for getting the filter coefficients you have to multiply your HDN by omega n or WN. So, n WN lies from 0 to 4, so your length will be the 5, and also at the end you have to determine your frequency response finally of FIR digital filter from its HN or from its impulse response of having finite duration. So, for this, at first you have to calculate HDN. You know the formula of HDN, that is 1 upon 2 pi from the limit for the minus pi to pi, depends upon the lying of the your function, HD e g omega e to power j omega n into d omega. Now, you put the values according to the limits. So, you have to put here minus pi by 2 pi by 4, its value is e to the power minus j 2 omega into a key power j omega n into d omega, plus 1 upon 2 pi e to the power minus j 2 omega e key power j omega n into d omega for the limit of pi by 4 to pi. Now, you combine this exponential function. So, it will be e to the power j omega n minus 2 into d omega for the limit of minus pi to minus pi by 4. Similarly, 1 upon 2 pi, pi by 4 to pi, its value is e to the power j omega n minus 2 into d omega. Now, if you solve this, so you will get HDN is equal to this one in terms of sine function. So, your impulse response of infinite duration, that is HDN is equal to 1 upon pi n minus 2 into sine of pi n minus 2 minus sine n minus 2 into pi by 4. Here I am writing here n is not equal to 2, because if you put n is equal to 2, so your HDN does not exist. So, at the 2, small n is equal to 2, you have to you can calculate the value. So, you have to apply here L'Hospital rule, then L'Hospital rule that says that you have to differentiate numerator and denominator separately, then you can get the value on that point. So, at n is equal to 2, you have to calculate HD2 by using L'Hospital rule. If you calculate this, then you will get HD2 is equal to 3/4. Again, you are using HD0, again a small n is equal to put 0. So, if you put the 0, then your value HD0 is equal to 1/2 pi. Similarly, HD1 is equal to, if you put here a small n is equal to 1, so it will be what? Pi, 1 n small n is equal to 1. So, HD1 is equal to 1/√2 into pi. Okay. So, and the other coefficients, because it lies from the for the other values. So, you put the value of what property of symmetricity, that is h n is equal to h m minus 1 minus n, here m is equal to 5. So, if you put h is n is equal to 0, so it will be 5 minus 1, so h of 4. So, here 0 is equal to h d 4. Similarly, here h d 1 is equal to h d 3 and h d 2 is there. So, you are calculating here the value of filter coefficients from h d 0 to h d 4. Now, these h d and filter coefficients are of infinite duration. To make it finite, you have to apply window function that is given in the problem. Your window function, you know, your window function is defined, it is 1 from 0 to 4. So, omega n is equal to 1 1 1 1 1, from 0 to 4 its value is 1. So, h n is equal to h d n into w n. So, it is 1 from 0 to 4. So, there is no effect of h n, and the same value you will get for the final filter coefficient of finite duration in FIR filter design. So, h of n is equal to at 0 its value is 1 upon 2 pi, at 1 its value is 1/√2 pi, at 2 its value is 3/4, at 4 its value is -1/2 pi. This is a simple value, you have to put the values of small n, you will get the h of n. So, these are your filter coefficients, okay? 0, 1, 2, at 0 this, at 1, at 2, at 3, it will be 2 it is 3/4, at 3 it is 1/√2 pi, at 4 it is -1/2 pi. So, these are the your filter coefficient values, okay? At 0 start from 0 this. So, the first part of the question you have solved here, filter coefficient. Now, you have to determine frequency response. So, you know the formula of frequency response, h e j omega is equal to summation from n 0 to 4 h of n into e to the power minus ka j omega n. So, you put the values here. So, it will be what? H of 0 e ki power 0 to 1 plus h of 1 e ki power minus ka j omega plus h of 2 e to the power minus ka 2 j omega plus h of 3 e to the power minus ka 3 j omega plus h of 4 e to the power minus ka 4 j omega. Then you have to put the value h of 0, h of 1, h of 2, h of 3, h of 4. When you put the values of these all filter coefficient, so finally, then you will get this term of frequency response in terms of cosine terms. Okay. So, if you see the frequency response of this for the high pass filter, and we did the same for low pass filter. So, there is a minute difference on that frequency response, some additive terms are additive in each other. But here your some terms are negative in each other. So, response is so different. In case of for the particular filter, for low pass filter and high pass filter, the response will be different. Okay. So, in this way you can solve the question if the window function and some digital filter specification or its frequency domain is given to you, or any band pass filter any filter specification is given to you. You can determine easily impulse response of FIR digital filter with its filter coefficients, then you can determine the other things also. Okay. Let's we take another example. So, another example is what? A filter is to be designed with the following desired frequency response as d e j omega is equal to e to the power minus ka j 3 omega from minus 3 pi by 4 to 3 plus 3 pi by 4. Otherwise, it will be 0. Again, it is low pass, like a low pass filter. You can see here, because it passes from up to this frequency, and for this frequency its value is 0. It means it does not pass the signal. Now, determine the h e g omega for m power 7 is equal to 7 for using the Hamming. Now, the window function is different here. In previous two examples, we take the rectangular window function or constant window function, but here we are using Hamming window function. So, we know the expression for Hamming window. Generally, in the question it is given to you. Okay. So, from that you can calculate the values of this Hamming window. So, here your m is equal to 7 is given to you. It means from n is equal to 0 to 6. At first you have to determine h d n. So, h d n is equal to 1 upon 2 pi, the simple formula is there, integration minus pi to pi h d e j omega into e to the power plus ka j omega n into d omega. So, this is the formula of inverse Fourier transform for this function. Now, you put the values here, 1 upon 2 pi integration minus 3 pi by 2 plus 3 pi by 4 e to the power minus ka j 3 omega into e ki power plus j omega n into d omega. Now, you associate these two exponential terms. So, you will get 1 upon 2 pi e to the power j omega n minus 3 into d omega. Now, if you solve this numerical and put the values of limits, upper limit and lower limits, then you will get this h d of n. And this h d n is equal to sin of 3 pi n minus 3 upon 4 upon sin of pi n minus 3. Here I am writing here n is not equal to 3. It means if you put here small n is equal to 3, then your h d n does not exist. So, in this case you have to apply L'Hospital rule for getting the value at small n is equal to 3. What is L'Hospital rule? You have to differentiate separately numerator and denominator part of the expression. If you here separately differentiate numerator and denominator part, so you will get it is 3 by 4. So, at small n is equal to 3, its value is 3 by 4. For other value, if you put here small n is equal to 0, so sin, if you put here h d 0 is equal to small n is equal to 0, so sin 3 pi minus 3 upon 4 upon pi into minus 3. So, it will be minus of sin 9 pi by 4 upon minus 3 pi. So, if you solve this or you calculate the values of sin and some constant value, so you will get h d 0 is equal to 0.0750. If you put again small n is equal to 1, so it will be you will get what 0.15 minus ka 0.15.
Similarly, you can calculate all other values HD 0 to HD 6. And you can also apply here the formula of symmetricity, that is H of n is equal to H of m minus 1 minus n. It means H of 0 is equal to what? Here m is equal to what? Here m is equal to 7. So, it will be 7 minus 1, it means 6. It means H 0 is always equal to the H 6. So, if you see here, okay. So, both are same. Similarly, H of 1 is equal to H of 5. Similarly, H of 2 is equal to H of 4. So, in this way, the again your filter coefficients are same in each other by this formula. Okay. And you will calculate here the all the values. Okay. So you have to calculate only 3 to 4 values and other values are automatically are equal in each other. Now, you can calculate all the values. Now, this is the digital filter coefficient, but we are interested to calculate your finite duration impulse response or filter coefficient, that is small h of n. Now, window function, you are having window function. So, how you make this h of n? So, we know h of n is equal to your h d n into w n. W n what? W n is your window function. In the question, window function is different now. Window function is type of like Hamming window function is given to you. Okay, Hamming. So, we know the w h n, that is the Hamming window function. For Hamming window function, this condition is there. What? The Hamming window function from 0 to m minus 1, so for this question 0 to 6, okay. Yeah. Its value will be the 0.54 minus 0.46 cos of 2 pi n upon m minus 1. Otherwise, it will be 0. So, for m is equal to 7, you can calculate the window function value from small n 0 to 7. So, at 0, if you put here a small n is equal to 0 and m is equal to 7. So, you will get window function at 0 is 0.08, at 1 it is 0.31, at 2 it is 0.77. You can solve this by simple calculator and put up the values of small n. And finally, you can calculate the value of window function from small n 0 to 6, say at 3, at 4, at 5 and at 6. So, these are your window function from small n 0 to 6. So, now you know h of n is finally is multiplication between the h d n and window function. So, here h, if you want to calculate h 0, so it will be what? It will be your h d 0 into w h 0. If you put both the value, then you will get some numerical value, that is 0.006. Similarly, here you put here h d 1 into w h 1. So, you will get the value of this one, that is minus 0.0494. Okay. Similarly, it will be h d 2 into w h 2. So, you will get this value. Similarly, h 3 3 is equal to your h d 3 into w h 3. So, you will get 0.75 value. Similarly, h 4, h 5, h 6. In this way, you can calculate all the filter coefficients available for the filter, because here your length of the filter is 7. So, the coefficient will be from 0 to 6. So, these are your h 0 to h 6 are the filter coefficients. Now, at the last, what you are interested to calculate frequency response. Again, you can use the formula, that is summation from n 0 to m minus 1 h of n into e to the power minus ka j omega n, where capital M is equal to 7, length of the filter is 7. So simply you can use the formula,
or you have to put here the values. Okay, so what h 0 into plus h 1 into e key power h 2 into e key power plus up to the h 6 into e key power minus ka j 6 omega. So, you can you have to put the values of h 0, h 1, h 2 up to the h 6 with exponential components, then it forms some cosine formulas in terms of exponential function. That is, we know also what e to the power j theta plus e to the power minus ka j theta upon 2 is equal to cos theta, and finally you will get this answer. So, in this way, if your window function is different, so your frequency response and your filter coefficients will be different. Your filter coefficients are decided by the window function also, that which type of window function you are taking for your desired application. If it is rectangular, so simply it will multiply by simple constant value of that window function and you can get the answer. If your window function is some other type, then fixed value like Hamming, Hanning, Geiser or other type of window function. So, your filter coefficients will be different, but definitely your filter coefficient is for FIR filter, because that will be for finite duration FIR digital filter. I hope it is clear to you. Now, you can design any type of FIR digital filter using window function. It is very easy and simple approach. You have to apply simple formula of inverse Fourier transform, then you can recover your digital filter coefficients. Now, window function is given to you. So, finally, getting the filter coefficients, you have to multiply that window function into your filter coefficient, then finally, you can get the what your filter coefficients for particular FIR digital filter. And if in the question frequency response is also asked from you, so you can also use the simple formula of getting the frequency response for particular impulse response of digital filter. Okay, so this is the your window technique methods of FIR filter designing. Other methods are also available. Okay, so we will discuss. So next is your Fourier series method. You know Fourier series. Fourier series generally used for the periodic type of system or function. If periodicity is there, so Fourier series will be there definitely. In Fourier series method, generally three constants in terms of trigonometric you can calculate, like a 0, a n, p n. If you are expressing your function in trigonometric form, okay. So, the frequency response of the filter is periodic with a period of 2 pi, and any periodic function can be expressed under this. So, if the Fourier series method you want to determine the filter coefficients or impulse response or FIR digital filter, so you find some filter coefficients. So, steps for this method: choose desired frequency response as usual as the windowing technique h e j omega, calculate Fourier series coefficient from it, it gives that h t n for the filter. Now, according to the Fourier coefficient a 0, a n and Bn, you determine the your digital filter coefficients. Now, truncate the infinite sequence to into the n finite number of sequences. Like in window techniques, you require to multiply your window function with HDN. So, here you have to truncate the infinite sequence HDN into finite duration Hn. Now, At the last, you have to take your Z transform for getting the frequency response, and finally, you are having frequency response of your digital filter. And finally, at the last, very important thing, finally convert your realizable causal FIR filter by multiplying what? Z to the power n minus 1 upon 2 factor. Generally, finally, you have to convert your digital filter into realizable causal FIR filter, and it is possible in this method by multiplying the Z to the power minus ka n minus 1 upon 2, where capital N is the number of sequences, okay, or you can say here length of the filter. So, this was your Fourier series method. So, in this, by the Fourier series method, you can also determine, you can also design your FIR digital filter easily. Now, the last, frequency sampling method. This approach is based upon the sampled signal and find out the required digital filter from its sampled signal. So, here you have to recover at first your samples from the frequency response, and after that you have to convert your filter specification into the FIR digital causal realizable filter. So, in this some steps are given to you. So, at first your HEJ omega is given to you, take n samples of this and generate H of k. It means you have to generate its sampled signal H of k. It means you have to convert your frequency domain into frequency domain, because H of k is also frequency domain signal. Now, from the H of k, if you want to convert it into time domain signal, so you have to require inverse transform. So, H of k is the Fourier transform of discrete finite duration signal. So, you have to take here H of n. So, H of n is equal to, it will be IDFT of what? H of k. So, you will get H of n and calculate the transfer function H z. So, here you require reconstruction of samples, okay. Then taking the IDFT, you will be having your H of n or filter coefficient. That is why it is called frequency sampling method. From the frequency domain, at first you recover your samples in frequency domain, and after the recovering your samples in frequency domain, you can detect your time domain H of n signal. And at the final, if you want to your frequency domain of your H of n, then you can take the its frequency transform or Z transform. So, thank you very much. So, in this way you can design your FIR digital filter easily by these methods that will be physically realizable. So, there are three methods. First is your windowing techniques. Okay. So, some window functions are available. You can design by window function, that for any particular window function help, you can design your FIR digital causal realizable filter. Similarly, you can design FIR digital filter by using frequency sampling or Fourier series method. So, all the best to all of you.